There was a total stranger in your bed. Oh, ooh. See, so cute. Has the pillow seen me do things? Are you really my pillow? I'm uncomfortable, excuse me. Why are you sweaty? Why is it hot in here? My pillow left. Hello, my name is Scylla and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today we are going to be playing a game called Comfort Pillow. I found this randomly. It is like a visual novel style game, kind of like your boyfriend, I believe. It also has yandere themes, so if you're not okay with that, don't watch this video. Otherwise, let's go ahead and get started. If you like this video, please like it. If you dislike it, dislike it. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel to support me and also click on the bell for notifications. I post every Sunday at 9 a.m. All right, let's have fun. Let's start. This game contains yandere theme and strong languages. Viewer discretion is advised. Ellipsis point. A longer ellipsis point. The feeling of consciousness hits you as you stare at the ceiling. Lately, nothing good was coming to you. No job, no friends, and you still have university to go through. Interesting background. A wave of heavy thoughts hits you and you immediately sit up. You're not planning on having a pity party so early in the morning. The view of your messy room entered your vision. You keep telling yourself you should clean it up soon, but never have the motivation to. You flop down back on bed. You didn't have class today, so you don't know what you're supposed to do. You turn to the side of the bed, trying to find your comfort pillow, and you're wondering if you could just sleep for the rest of the day. Imagine. Like you have a comfort like plushie or a pillow or a blanket, and then you just see a human. However, instead of seeing the pillow on your side, you see a person. Look at the little sparkles on the sides. They look like an angel with how peaceful they look as they sleep, their whole body calm as it moves in rhythm with their breathing. Their face was uncomfortably close to yours, and only now did you realize something. There was a total stranger in your bed. You let out a scream as you crawl away from the stranger, shaking as you feel them staring in their sleep. They sat up from the bed and rubbed their eyes, looking confused as their gaze darted around your room before looking at you. Oh, ooh, see, so cute. They smile gently at you before noticing your fearful face. Their expression switched to a worried one. Question mark. Gummy, are you okay? What happened? Who are you? And what are you doing in my room? They give you a confused expression before something similar to hurt was on their face. Illo. Illo? What are you saying? It's me, Illo. Don't you remember your dear pillow? What? What are they talking about? Last time you remembered your pillow was not a human, even if their appearance and name matches up with what you've imagined it to be. Don't play games with me. Who are you? The person ponders for a while as they put their hand over their mouth, deep in thought. How about I prove it to you? You can ask me some questions and I'll answer them. Oh God, has the pillow seen me do things? What are you going to do? Accept the offer. While you're hesitant to follow their suggestion, it does sound plausible. If they really are who they say they are, then they should know basic information about you. All right then, first question. My name is, what is your name? Scylla. Scylla, of course. How could I not know your name? Silly. Wrong! That's not my name. I'm hurt. You think that I wouldn't know something as important as your name. They are correct, but it might be because your name is pretty common around your town. It is not. Alright, you're correct, but it's only because my name is common around here. Second question. My favorite hobby is... What is your favorite hobby? Hiking. Hiking, of course. While I personally don't understand it, I can appreciate your love for it. They give you a warm smile. You strangely felt comforted by that statement. People usually don't like what you're into, so it was nice to hear someone who appreciated what you like. The bar is so low. All right. You also don't have a job right now, and you recently have had a falling out with your friends. What? How do they know about that? You never told anyone that. You're also a very insecure person who pushed their own emotions down because you deemed it as unnecessary. Incorrect for me personally, but all right, go off. You crave your validation every day and try your hardest to prove to people you're useful, even if it drained you. Okay, be a little gentler. You talk to yourself and made up imaginary friends because of how lonely you are and pretend they're your real friends. All right, I get it. Are you really my pillow? The person, Illo, beamed at your question and nodded enthusiastically. In the flesh, I always wanted to make that joke. Lol. They chuckled, and you awkwardly let out a laugh. Maybe you are being too harsh on them. Maybe they really are your beloved pillow. Maybe all of your cries of loneliness were finally answered, and Illo was proof of it. You woke me up earlier than usual today. Do you want to go back to sleep? I'll be here with you. Yeah, I'd like that. You stood up from the corner of your room and walked back to your bed. Laying down next to Illo, you looked straight to the ceiling, still feeling flustered with someone being in your bed, even if they are literally your pillow. Haha, are you shy? It's okay. I'm still the same pillow you know and love. Come closer. Your face flushed red as you looked into their eyes, suddenly feeling shy at the intimate feeling. Illo chuckles at your awkwardness before pulling you close to them and hugged you. Startled at the gesture, you were going to pull away but are comforted by the familiar smell of your pillow. The smell has always calmed you down. Say, Illo? They perked up at the mention of their name and you felt their body shudder a bit. Yes, Gummy? What is it? Why you call me Gummy? Is that my pet name from them? Wait. Why do you call me that? Oh. It's because of how you hugged me, dummy. You always cling to me so much it reminded me of a gummy bear. How do you know what gummy bears are? You feel your face heat up at their answer. It's true that you did that, but it'd be better if they just lied about it instead of teasing you about it. Never mind that. How did you even turn into this? Illo looks down at you for a moment, pondering how they should answer this. You stare back patiently as they let out a sigh. It's funny, really. Do you know how Pinocchio came alive? It's sort of like that. Seeing you suffer so much and so harsh on yourself, I wish day and night I could have a physical body to be here for you, to comfort you. When it finally came true, I was so happy, but I understand why it startled you. I didn't have the heart to wake you up, though. You were sleeping so peacefully. Haha. Ellipsis point plus two periods. Dumbfounded at what they said, you bury your face closer to their chest in embarrassment. Huh? Nobody has told you how much they care for you. The bar is so low. And see that such a person or pillow was hoping to turn into a human just to be with you is, thank you. You don't really have much else to say. It was all a little overwhelming to you. Letting out a small smile, you rest your whole body, feeling yourself falling back into a deep slumber. He didn't say that. I think that's not supposed to be there. That's just like a narration of your actions. He was cuddling with this strange man. You heard Illo mumbling something to themselves, but by that point, you were already asleep in the comfort of their embrace. That was like two ellipsis points. Oh, Scylla. Excuse me? I'm uncomfortable, excuse me? Why are you sweaty? Why is it hot in here? Is that my head? I think that's my head. Why is it hot in here? Illo sighed as they pulled your sleeping figure closer to them, their whole body shaking in excitement at the close proximity the two of you are sharing. You feel me every day. I sleep in you every day. You're so cute, but you're not very bright. Bitch. Bitch? I'm so glad to finally have you in my arms. Illo looked at you in endearment, their lovesick gaze locking tight into the top of your head as they bury themselves into it and take a deep sniff. Don't smell me. That pillow of yours. It sounded silly, but I was so jealous of it. Ha, jealous of an inanimate object. I guess I really am deep into this. No matter. It proved to be useful after all. I'm finally here, with you. Nothing is between us anymore. Oh, it's red! It's red. Sleep tight, gummy. I love you. Ayy. Wait, I only had one choice to make and they gave me one and there's two endings to this game, so I guess it's easy to get the other ending. True end, your comfort. Okay. Can I skip? I think I can skip. Heck no. Hell no, who do you think you are? Get out! Get out of my room! Wait, calm down, Gummy. I said out! Haha, he left. My pillow left! The stranger hurried and ran out of your room, leaving you alone once again. You sighed as you lied back on your bed. Seriously, who did they think they were? Entering in your room like that? You decided to just spend the rest of the day sleeping. That whole ordeal kills all of your motivation to do anything else today. I guess. Grumbling, you close your eyes, letting the darkness consuming you as you ponder what's going to happen next tomorrow. But there was this burning feeling at the back of your head. Almost as if there was someone watching you. Is he gonna come after me? That was version one of this game. I don't know if it'll be updated again, but it looks like there were only two endings. I got both of them. I got a good ending, I guess, and the bad ending, I guess, which is interesting. I like the visuals of the game. It was very cute. It was a little bit shocking for me to see the first ending that I got, where they were just like, they were like breathing so hard over you. That was a little bit interesting, to say the least. I'm very intrigued by the second ending that I got, where it's called Angered. I guess we made them angry. I want to know what they're going to do. I hope that this game gets updated because I want to see other chapters. I want to see what they do. I liked everything about this game. It was very short and sweet. It took me like under 10 minutes to go through. You just go through the dialogue once and then you skip through and you press the second answer basically. Yeah, I guess that's it for this game. I mean, I would play it again if they had other chapters, but they don't have any other chapters, so that's all that I can say. If you liked this video, please like it. If you disliked it, please dislike it. And subscribe to support my YouTube channel. Also click the bell for notifications. And I post every Sunday at 9 a.m. So I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.